The Sierpinski Triangle is one of the most famous fractals. It's named after Polish mathematician Wacław Sierpinski and is pictured here. However, imagery of the triangle appeared centuries earlier. For instance, Cosmatest tilings from the 11th century contained this kind of image. This is from a basilica in San Clemente. There are even hints that early versions can be traced to mythical ancient battles between Link and Ganon. Let's explore six mathematical techniques that can be used to build this amazing fractal. For our first method, we start with an equilateral triangle and subdivide it into four congruent equilateral triangles and remove the middle one. Then we repeat this process on the three remaining equilateral triangles, and we repeat this process again on the nine remaining equilateral triangles, and so on. We can continue this process as many times as we need to get a good approximation of the Sierpinski triangle. In theory, this process goes on forever, and so as we zoom in on the Sierpinski triangle, each shape should look exactly the same as the one we started with. This really is a self-similar figure. The second technique uses the so-called chaos game. We again begin with an equilateral triangle, and this time we start with a dot somewhere in the middle. We randomly choose one of the three vertices, and then we draw a line between the dot and that vertex and plot the midpoint. Now repeat the process, each time starting at the dot we have, drawing to a random vertex, and plotting the midpoint. If we continue this process a number of times, we will actually end up producing the Sierpinski triangle. Though it's seemingly random, it produces order. Let's see what it looks like when we repeat this process 30,000 times. The next construction requires us to use the Halayudha-Pascal triangle. Let's build this number triangle, but we'll only investigate the first few rows to begin with. In this number triangle, the 0th row, or the top, contains a 1, and the first row contains two 1s. Now each entry in the triangle can be obtained as the sum of the two entries directly above it. So we always begin each row with a 1, and then we get 1 plus 2 for this entry, and 2 plus 1 for the next entry. And the final entry in the row is always 1. Let's see this one more time for the 4th row. We can continue filling in each row using this pattern, where each entry is the sum of the two entries above it. With this arithmetic triangle in hand, you can go entry by entry and shade a cell if the entry is odd, and leave the cell unshaded if the entry is even. The pattern you get for the first rows looks like this. But now let's continue this pattern by extending the Pascal triangle all the way out to row 256 and shading only the odd entry cells. Sure enough, there's the Sierpinski triangle. Can you explain why it appears? For our next construction, we iteratively build a ternary branching tree. To do this, we start with a line of unit length, and we apply three transformations. Each transformation scales by 0.5 and rotates by a multiple of 2 pi over 3. Then we apply these transformations again to the branches, and we repeat this as many times as we need, always applying the three transformations to the branches. At the end, if we remove all of the branches along the way, the resulting set of leaves will look like the Sierpinski triangle. Our next construction requires us to introduce a partial order on the set of positive integers. We say that k is bitwise dominated by n if each bit of n is greater than or equal to the corresponding bit of k. For example, here are all the binary representations for the integers from 0 to 6. Notice that we've padded each representation with zeros at the beginning to make sure that all of these integers have binary representations that are the same length. Let's check to see if 0 is bitwise dominated by 6. We do see that in fact that each bit of 6 is greater than or equal to the corresponding bit of 0. So therefore 0 is bitwise dominated by 6. But for 1, notice that the very last bit, 0, is not greater than or equal to 1. So we say that 1 is not bitwise dominated by 6. We can then go through each integer between 0 and 6 and check for bitwise dominance. In this case, we see that 2 is bitwise dominated by 6, but we see that 3 is not. Four is bitwise dominated by 6, but again, 5 is not because of the last bit. And finally, the definition implies that each number bitwise dominates itself. Using this partial order, we consider a row of 7 hexagons called row 6. Each hexagon represents one of the integers from 0 to 6. We put a Y for yes in the cell if that hexagon number is dominated by the row number. Otherwise, we put an N for no. You can see that this row succinctly contains all the information we found about bitwise dominance by 6. Let's repeat this process for each positive integer and organize the information in a triangular array. In this triangular array, entry K in row N will indicate if K is bitwise dominated by N. We've already seen row 6 has this information. Using the process that we described before, we can fill in the rest of the rows just by checking for bitwise dominance, like this. Just like we did for Pascal's triangle, let's extend this bitwise dominance triangle out to row 256 and see what we see. You should already see the outline of Pascal's triangle in the yeses, but if we fade out the noes and then highlight the yeses this way, we see a clearer picture of the Sierpinski triangle. The final construction that we present is called the Arrowhead construction. For this technique, we first begin with a line segment of unit length. We are going to iteratively replace line segments in the following manner. We replace horizontal lines by this trapezoidal shape, 60 degree angles line by this trapezoidal shape, and negative 60 degree angle lines by this trapezoidal shape. So in round 1, we take the horizontal line and replace it with this shape. Now we replace each of the 3 lines with the trapezoidal shapes, and we continue this process for as many iterations as we want. Once again, after enough iterations, you can't tell the difference between this and the Sierpinski triangle. And sure enough, in the limit, they will be the same. So that concludes our 6 techniques for constructing the Sierpinski triangle. Can you find other constructions